Hello and welcome back to the channel. As I look around, as we all look around, things are not looking good, family. And so many of us, we are talking about this, we are sounding the alarm. And many of you have realized this a long time ago, but there are so many that don't realize it. And you can see it in their day-to-day actions. It's really sad to watch as loved ones, friends, people in your community, or just people in general, walk about or mosey about as if nothing bad is happening in the world. As if they are waiting for everything to just snap back into shape and that they're going to experience some type of normalcy. The handwriting has been on the wall for a long time now, but as I look at various factions within the so-called black community, there are some that are completely oblivious to what's going on. Of course, you have those who are paying attention and are moving and acting accordingly, but there are too many who are not. And we don't see how all of this can affect us on an individual level when you see someone who's across town, perhaps, or across country, who's just going about life as if nothing is wrong, as if there's nothing to be concerned about or worried about. We don't see how that can affect us on an individual basis because we're like, look, I'm handling my business. I'm doing what I'm supposed to do. And so I need not concern myself about the next fella. That's easier said than done if you've never lived in total chaos. So it remains to be seen for many people as to what things are going to look like when everything finally does go topsy-turvy. I look at people and I feel sad because you have those that are so invested in what this world has to offer that they have no time to fortify themselves. Some of them don't even believe that anything is happening to where they need to even concern themselves with fortifying themselves, right? You see young people so into entertainment. You see old people into entertainment. Nonsense here, nonsense there, foolishness everywhere. This is what we see happening. But are we paying attention to the food crisis? Are we paying attention to the water crisis? And I'm not just talking about water shortage, I'm talking about water contamination. There are so many things that people are not paying attention to that it makes you wonder, should I just stop right here and say, let everybody figure it out for themselves? A lot of people are doing just that. They're like, look, I'm going to just let folk figure it out for themselves, but I'm going to keep forging ahead. But some of us, we've got to continue to sound the alarm while we're forging ahead. Some would say that it can slow you down a bit concerning yourself with others. But if this is what you are called to do, then you must do it. You must do it. If you see that there is danger and someone needs to be warned about something, you don't want their blood on your hands, so you must warn the people. Over the years, I have seen the results of telling people or warning people about what is to come. Many have shared their testimonies about how watching our videos actually encouraged them to start farming or gardening or even buying land. And that is encouraging in and of itself when someone actually tells you, look, because of the things that you talk about, this is why I'm growing food today. When I look at the world, family, I do look at it from a standpoint of faith because I trust our Creator, okay? I trust and believe that He is going to work things out for our good as long as we are doing what we are supposed to do. But at the same time, when you look at others, it's kind of difficult for some of us to look at others and say, that's your problem. That's his problem. That's her problem. This is why I continue to sound the alarm. When I look at the economy, I see just how bad things are. I see just how bad things are. It's very, very difficult to watch. We don't know from one day to the next what is going to happen. We don't know from one day to the next. I'm looking at a story on my screen right now that I may share. These are the kinds of things that we continue to see. that just shakes us to the core, family. It shakes us to the core because there are some horrendous things happening in the world, and you say to yourself, oh my goodness, what are we doing? What is happening? Why are people so blind? There's a battle over everything you can imagine. And frankly, I'm tired of all of the senseless battles over ignorant things. While the crap is hitting the fan, you have people battling over ignorant things. Straight up ignorant things. And you say to yourself, do you even know what's happening in the world? Are you even paying attention? Do you realize that there are moves being made behind the scenes and up front that are going to directly affect your life? Moves that are being made. Decisions and choices out here that are being made that are going to affect your life. And see, a lot of people like to wait until things start happening before they start to scurry about and try to do this or make this move or make that change. That's the wrong time to be trying to make moves. The time to fortify and set your life up is now. What is the point of waiting until, what they say, the crap hits the fan before you decide you want to do something? That is not the time to scurry about. The time to make haste is now. You have a decision to make. You have to decide, what are you going to do with your life? Because they've been telling us for a very long time. They've been telling us that there's going to be no help for you when it's all said and done. When everything comes to a head, there is going to be no help. Folk are always thinking and waiting and contemplating help, but it's not always going to be there. Is not always going to be there. Excuse me for one moment here. Just one moment. Okay. But anyway, I just wanted to chime in on this subject because things are really getting to a frightening point. Of course, we are not to fear when I say this. There are going to be some frightening things happening in the world, and unfortunately, most people are not going to be prepared for it. They have no idea because they are not even trying to understand. They are not even trying to know, not even trying to find out. And these are going to be the very ones that I speak about, I've spoken about often over the years, that are going to try to come over someone else's fence or kick in someone else's door or breach someone else's property to try to get what they need to survive when they can be doing it now. Some people just don't take life serious at all. And so therefore, they make no preparations. Because in their minds, some people haven't said it verbally, but already in their minds, because it's already set up in them, it's already a part of them. Some people are already and set to try to take what somebody else have when the time comes. Because they know they haven't prepared. In the back of their minds, they know something is coming, but they are making no preparations whatsoever. And so those who do prepare, you also have to prepare for those kind of people. This is what I mean when I say you can't assume that something that someone else is or isn't doing or going through isn't going to affect you. You have to settle up in your mind that if someone wants to breach your doorstep, your property line, or your life because they didn't prepare, you have to make up in your mind that you are going to protect what is yours. Because people are not paying attention to the handwriting on the wall. They are not listening or seeing the signs. They are not even concerning themselves with any of that. Now, we don't say these things to cause you to fear. No one is trying to get you to fear, but we're trying to get you to think and understand and recognize what is at hand, what is at stake. That's what you need to do. That's what we all need to do Take heed. Open our eyes. Prepare. Stop messing around. And also, be prepared to leave others behind. If folk don't want to listen, they don't want to pay attention, they want to continue to play fool's games, you have to be prepared to leave them behind and forge ahead. Especially if you have children. Especially if you have children. But if there are those who are not trying to do anything, but they have wickedness set all up in their minds, all prepared to come and take what others have, be prepared to do what you have to do. I want to know what your thoughts are in the comment section about what I'm talking about here. Whether you have prepared, whether you're thinking about it, whether this has encouraged you to prepare. Let me know what your thoughts are in the comment section. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channel, share and like this video, and with that, I'm out. Be sure to ring the bell to be notified of new uploads on this channel, and also comment, share, like, and subscribe.